bid us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that by St. Joseph's intercession, your church may constantly watch over the unfolding of the mysteries of human salvation, whose beginnings you entrusted with faithful care. We ask all this for Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the image of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you. 6. When your days are ended, and you are laid to rest with your ancestors, I will preserve the offspring of your body after you, and make his sovereignty secure. It is he who shall build a house for my name, and I will make his royal throne secure forever. I will be a father to him, and he a son to me. Your house and your sovereignty will always stand secure before me, and your throne be established forever. This is the word of the Lord.
Responsorial Psalm, the response is, his dynasty shall last forever.
His dynasty shall last forever.
Descendants will be as many as the stars.
This is the claim that was considered as justified in. Brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord.
Every year, the parents of Jesus go to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went out for the feast as usual. When they were on their way home after the feast, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem without his parents knowing it. They assumed he was with the caravan, and it was only after a day's journey that they went to look for him among the relations and acquaintances. When they failed to find him, they went back to Jerusalem looking for him everywhere. 3 days later, they found him in the temple, sitting among the doctors, listening to them and asking them questions. And all those who heard him were astounded at his intelligence and his deep rise. They were overcome when they saw him, and his mother said to him, "My child, why have you done this to us? See how worried your father and I have been looking for you. Why are you looking for me?" he cried. "Did you not know that I must be busy with my father's affairs?" But they did not understand what he meant. He then went down with them and came to Nazareth and lived under their authority. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the year about 1879, the very first Catholic missionaries landed in Uganda. And 100 years later, in 1979, we celebrated the first 100 years of free Catholic faith in Uganda. And the priest from Goodwood Diocese composed a song to remind us why the missionaries came here. And the song was "Marching United in Whom?" And I think, as I did my reflection, I would like to invite you to sing that full song. Focus ourselves where the missionaries came and remind us of Christ. And I think our choir is good, very good to lead us in doing this. When you march, do you see it or you stand?
Oh,
150 years the foundation of the Society of the Middle Fathers, let us unite and remain united in Christ our Lord. Your Excellency the Archbishop of Uganda, Your Eminence, Your Excellency the Archbishops present here, the bishops, the clergy, the religious, and especially the jubilarians today, the religious and laity, I wish to welcome you very warmly and heartily to this celebration and thank you for coming. We are here to give thanks to God Almighty for the gift of the missionaries of St. Joseph, the Mill Hill, whose congregation was founded, was erected 150 years ago. And in 1895, that's when they came to Uganda. So today we also remember 121 years since they founded their mission in Uganda. We thank God for the gift of His Son, Jesus Christ, whom He sent to redeem all of us, and through whom He founded this beautiful church, which we have to cherish, and also to continue uniting, and also being in communion with the church. Being in communion with the church requires three elements. One, the creed, as professed by the apostles, which we also profess every Sunday. Two, the seven sacraments that we celebrate. And three, the leadership of the church as Jesus Christ founded it. He chose 12 apostles, and then out of the 12, he chose the bishop to lead the others. So whenever we are in line with those three, we remain in communion.